Good evening and welcome, soccer fans. My name is Aiden Dauk.
And I'm Logan Thompson. We are brought to you live from Saputo Stadium, set for a game between the Kakana Galloping Ghosts, who are going up against your Pulaski Red Raiders.
This broadcast is provided by the Raider Strong Network and is made up of Pulaski High School students.
We'll be back for the start of the game shortly.
Pulaski is coming into this game having only played two games so far this year. Both happened on Saturday, just a few days ago, which is a little bit of a tough turnaround for them. We'll see if that affects this game, especially in the second half. We might see a little bit of fatigue here, and hopefully they can overcome that if they want to win this game. Pulaski starts off early. Veronica Decker on the left wing taking it down. That'll be cleared out for a throw-in.
Pulaski throw. In the two games that the Red Raiders have played so far, they've gone 1-1, losing 1-2 to Appleton East and winning 3-1 against West Bend.
Taking a look at Kakana on the flip side, the Galloping Ghosts have had their first game last Friday where they lost to Stevens Point 1-0. We'll see what they can do here tonight. They're looking to get that first victory of the season, and if they want to, they're going to have to shut down this Pulaski attack, who has been doing pretty good so far. I mean, we've only seen them twice, but they've combined for 4 goals in 2 games.
That is the goal kick.
Foul called, and the Galloping Ghosts will have a free kick. Pulaski had a really nice season last year, and they are welcoming back 9 seniors from that team. They went 15-4-5 and made it to the sectional semifinal, where they lost to West De Pere 2-0. Looking at Kakana again, they also lost to West De Pere last year to end their season, but that was the regional final, and they also lost 0-2.
Another throw-in for Kakana.
Here's Josie Stino on the ball.
Good passing by Pulaski.
Kakana takes over. If you didn't catch those starting lineups here, starting off in goal for Kakana is Larissa Likes. She's a junior. And then number 3, Kate Wood, is on the defense, as well as
that will go out. It will be a Pulaski throw-in. Intercepted there by Kakana. Pulaski looking to make a clear. And they'll have a free kick, and it'll be taken by the us.
That'll be Bella Logie.
Yeah, the junior.
Here's Sturdivant.
Good pass.
Trying to get that cross into the box there was Veronica Decker. Was committed to UWGB to play soccer.
Good drop kick there.
Ellie Mangold in pursuit.
And that will be another throw-in for Pulaski.
Stino controls it. Looking for Spreadman. They'll just maintain possession.
Just playing to keep away right now.
Pulaski in what looks to be a 4-3-3 to start off this game. We'll see if that changes.
Intercepted there by Pulaski. Is there? That one is sent out for
corner.
Yes, a corner. T- taking the corner will be, I think, number 11, Josie Stino.
She sends this one into the box.
Looking for the header.
Back out to Stino.
Nice cross. And that one will be retrieved by the keeper. I think it actually went out and it will be a goal kick. She just boots that one. Kakana.
Pulaski's defense able to stop that attack. But the counterattack was not on there. And
yeah, it goes out, and that will be another Kakana throw-in. Kakana going to look to try scoring here. Don't think that one went out. But that one surely did. And it'll be another Katakana throw in. This time, Pulaski will be the ones throwing it in. One is intercepted.
Sounds good. Yeah.
Here's Josie Stino trying to get the ball switched to the other side.
But it is stolen. Kakana looking. But that one went out, and it will be a Pulaski throw-in.
Leah Eisen tried to keep that one in. Here's Sturdivant to throw. Finds Decker. She shields and is unable to complete the pass to the left back there. Is that service? Foul throw. And Kakana will take over once again. Not too much for chances here early. Still settling into this game for both teams. Back lines have held pretty good. But it's just a couple minutes in. 8:30. Looked for the swing. Logie there to stop that.
Pulaski now.
Trying to find that last through ball to break through the back line.
Just haven't been able to get it yet. Be a Kakana throwing.
Kakana looking dangerous here. They've got runners.
Good stop, though, by Pulaski. Sturdivant looking through the pass. I think that's trucking broad.
Sends it all the way over
to Sturdivant. Just now, Kakana.
Ruth Kraus trying to battle for that ball.
Kakana now taking over. Oh. That one will be kicked out.
It's hard to tell here if Pulaski is in a 4-4-2 or 4-3-3. At first I thought Ruth Kraus might be playing the 9 at striker, but she might be playing a false 9 as well, coming back a little bit more. Well. Or they might just be in a... natural 4-4-2 with Decker and Mangold up top.
Oh. As it'll be a free kick for Kakana. Pulaski throw.
Bella Logi finds Spredeman and then Testino. Pulaski keeping possession, but they haven't really been able to move the ball horizontally here on the pitch.
Just been kind of that back and forth passing. Kakana could be looking for a cross here if that stays, and it will not. Throw in for Pulaski.
Stino with a little bit of room to turn. And here we go. Pulaski transitions to the attack.
Now they could be looking for something.
Veronica Decker is through.
Could be looking for a shot on goal. Saved there by the keeper. She just chucks that one out there.
That's what Pulaski's looking for, is those quick through balls. Finding Decker, who I believe was their leading scorer last year, left-footed striker. She's a senior this year.
Be a throw-in for Kakana.
Veronica Decker's got quite a bit of soccer in her blood there. Both of her brothers play as well. Austin Decker played for the Red Raiders a couple years ago now, the boys team, and then Gunnar Decker plays currently. He's just a freshman.
I wonder how you know all this. That will be a Kakana throw-in, I believe. Oh.
Once again, running over that Kakana starting lineup. Larissa Likes in net. Kate Wood, the defender. Taylor Lair in the midfield. Rowan Flanagan in the midfield. Kyla Labs, forward. Ava Mao, forward. Evelyn Duell, midfield. Nora Boucher. Tori Fisher, Aaliyah Eisen, and Madison Tripp will round out that starting squad. The Kakana throw.
And that one is over the goal. And that will result in the goal kick.
Cleared out of danger by the Kakana back line.
It'll be a throw-in.
Here's Josie Stino shielding the ball. She is committed to play Division III soccer for Eau Claire next year.
And that one is just right. And that will result in another goal kick for Kakana.
Kakana on the attack.
Pulaski looking to clear. This will be a Pulaski throw-in. Pulaski may have something here.
Ruth Kraus working at the top of the D. Stino quickly gets back on that. And Pulaski will keep possession through the back.
Passes Sturdivant. Be a Pulaski throw-in. Be another Pulaski throw-in. Pass to Sturdivant. Looking for the cross. Pulaski cannot score there.
For Kakana, number 20, Abigail Kirby. And in for the Raiders, number 2, Haley Jansen, and number 15, Tierney Gerbers.
If you didn't catch that substitution, Haley Jansen and Tierney Gerbers both came on for the Red Raiders, and then Abigail Khoury for the Galloping Ghosts.
Pulaski looking for a cross.
Good tackle there from Stino. Kraus with that shot.
It will result in a goal kick for Kakana. Pulaski just maintaining possession.
Service on the throw. Finds Decker. Who lays it back to service. Pulaski playing through the middle. Trying to get these quick connections. Lays it off. Here's the cross in. Unable to get on the end of that one.
And it will be a free kick for Kakana.
Big substitution here for the Ghosts.
In for Kakana, number 10, Ava Mao. Number 13, Maya Palmer. And number 16, Abigail Haynes.
Abigail Haynes. I believe it was Nora Foucher and Ava Mao. All coming in for Kakana. This game's still deadlocked at 0. It's the 24th minute.
Don't think there's been a single shot on the Pulaski goal. Service looking for someone. going to pass it to the keeper. He's going to boot it.
Fifty-fifty. Pulaski wins. Nice move there from Tori Fisher. Switch the field. Give the Ghosts a chance to attack.
Be a Kakana throw-in.
Pulaski goalkeeper Peyton Brandenburg comes up to claim that one. Foul from behind.
Be a free kick for Pulaski.
Quick substitution there.
The game for the Raiders, number 3, Brindley Sturdivant, and number 22, Ellie Mangold.
Pulaski subbed on Sarah Johnson there. And Brindley Sturdivant. Both teams still looking for that first goal. Defenses have been holding pretty well. Only a couple legitimate shot attempts.
And they've all been from Pulaski.
Pulaski with numbers forward.
Yeah. Looking to make something happen here.
And they'll have a corner.
It'll be Sturdivant taking it.
Stino goes short. They elect to just send it in. But Kakana is able to clean that up, but won't be able to launch a counterattack.
It's actually service will throw it in. be a free kick for Pulaski.
Dangerous territory here.
Stino will take the kick.
Surprised that they don't have Decker on this to have it swinging outward. Quality save from Larissa Likes.
So we have 10 minutes remaining in the first half.
You can tell that both these teams are very well coached and disciplined with their spacing. Yeah, they've been working it around really well here.
Because it'll be a Pulaski throw-in.
This game was anticipated to be close. Last year, I believe, Pulaski played them in another early season game, and they were able to get the victory 2-1. And it looks like this is another one that's going to come down to the wire. Close battle here. But who will strike first? Got an injury after a foul. Hard to tell which player's down. This is never good to see. The referees stop the clock. It's the 32nd minute. Still 0-0. That was Lillian Lam, number 2. Good to see that she was able to walk off the field. Hopefully she's able to return.
In for Kakana, number 17, Tori Fisher. And in for the Raiders, number 5,
Brandon Berg able to claim that one.
Going to be a free kick taken by
Isabella Logie. Excellent defending and then able to draw that foul, get the Red Raiders out of danger. She elects to go short, just keep possession.
It's Going to be another free kick for Pulaski. It's going to be taken by Stino. So we hit the 34th minute. Kukana may have something. Good save there by Brandenburg. Sturdivant with the header. We've hit the 35th minute. Sturdivant now dribbling. Nice kick.
All the way over. Half chance there for Mangold, unable to make anything of it.
This has been neck and neck. Brandenburg going to pick that one up as we are about to hit the 36th minute of the first half.
Isabella Logie, great tackle there. She's been playing very well tonight.
Sturdivant with the pass.
Bella Logie, a junior captain on this Red Raider back line.
And Sturdivant will take the throw in. My bad, it will be a corner kick. As we hit the 37th minute. The kick.
Both teams have had a couple of chances. Especially Kakana here later in this first half.
Sturdivant. It's going to be a Pulaski throw-in here at the 38th minute.
Kate Wood, the defender there.
Final 2 minutes of the half. See if one of these teams can cook something up.
Excellent defense there.
By Truck and Broad. Final 90 seconds. Yeah, what grounds could you, like, even shoot it at? Past the Sturdivant.
And here we go. Pulaski's on the attack now.
Here in the final minute. Be a throw in for Kakana. And that will cost him a bit of time. They got 45 seconds. Pulaski now going to try seeing if they can get something with these last 30 seconds. Sturdivant with the pass to15 seconds remain.
Where you 10, at? 9, 8, 7, 6.
Final five seconds.
4, 3,
expect
two,
a shot.
1.
Nope.
That should do it for the first half. Your score still 0-0.
We will be back in action after halftime. As thanks for tuning into the second half of action. This is a tie game between Pulaski and Kakana. Not many shots were put up in the first half.
Yeah, there hasn't been too much excitement yet with goals. Pretty even game so far. Not much for quality looks on net for either team, which is just probably a testament to both defenses.
Yeah, it's been more of a defensive battle.
Yeah.
But Pulaski early on almost had something. Going to go out for a corner, and I think that's going to be Brindley Sturdivant taking that. I think that, yeah, that's Sturdivant. This is a good opportunity for Pulaski, with only being a minute in, to get something quick here and put the pressure on Kakana. But that's good defense there from Kakana. Now Truckenbrod gonna just... Oh!
Pulaski trying to stop that attack.
I think Truckenbrod might have gotten hurt on that play.
Yeah, she will head off.
Yeah, she was very slow to get up on that one. The ref checked on her. Going to get her sub in. Subbing in is going to be... Number 16, Leah Kapla, the sophomore.
Kakana on the throw. In that first half, Pulaski was able to spread the ball around quite a bit. It'll be interesting to see that stat line, to see if they enjoyed the bulk of possession. I believe that they did. They also earned themselves a handful of corners. While I don't think that Kakana had any corners in that first half.
I don't think Kakana had a single corner.
I don't think Pulaski had to defend anything.
Pulaski did not have to defend a single shot because there were no shots from Kakana. So they're obviously going to look at to at least attempt to score this time.
Yeah, Pulaski really seemed to emphasize playing the ball through the middle with a couple quick combinations and decent crosses from the wing. We'll see if they try to continue
but
with
Kakana,
that philosophy.
Oh, good save by Brandon Berg. That was a very risky slide.
Aggressive goalkeeping. As far as Kakana goes in that first half, they also had some nice chances. Most were thwarted by Peyton Brandenburg, just like that. She was able to scoop up a couple, play aggressive, and clear away any danger around the 18. As far as this game goes, though, it's definitely there for either team.
And Brandenburg will pick that one up and see what she decides to do with it. She's going to drop kick it.
Kakana has been having some nice moments, especially on counterattacks, where they are just a few passes away from breaking the back line. Pulaski will definitely have to be aware of that and be disciplined moving forward. As well, Pulaski has been working the ball around quite a bit, comfortable in the back, but they need to stay focused back there. Because if they lose it in dangerous territory, that's exactly
Decker
what Kakana is looking for.
Looking for something there, couldn't get it. It will be a goal kick for Kakana.
Ruth Kraus does well to keep it for Pulaski. Veronica Decker with a chance.
Gonna look for the cross. Oh.
Decker's had a couple of nice runs. She is left-footed, so that's why they're trying to get it to her on that side. Give her a chance to cross.
As it will be a free kick for Kakana.
Interesting there. It looks like the linesman called it out originally.
As it looks like Truck and Broad comes back out. So she's definitely okay.
She'll push Megan Spreadman up into the midfield. Looks like she's playing the six. Oh, Boesky.
Had a shot there, but it was blocked by Kakana.
Streaking down the wing there.
Going to look for a cross, but it goes out.
That was Ava Mao on that deep run into Pulaski territory.
It's going to be a corner for Kakana, and they're going to elect to have... Madison Tripp take it. Just overshoots that one a little. It's going to be a goal kick for Pulaski.
Pulaski with a chance here on the attack.
A very good chance. Oh, just missed on that cross. Going to be a goal kick for Kakana.
Ellie Mangold, isolated in the corner.
It's going to go out for the cross.
Excellent work to win the corner.
And they're going to have Brinley Sturdivant take it, I believe. No, that's going to be Steno.
Kana's done well defending these corners so far. We'll see what they can do.
That was a good kick right there. Just, oh, shot on goal. Good save by the keeper. That's probably been the closest Pulaski's gotten to a goal so far in. Good drop kick from the keeper.
He's just going to keep possession.
Throw in for Kakana. Chuck and Barad going to take the throw in for Pulaski. Steno now going to take the throw in.
Seems to be quite a bit of space on the wings for both teams. It'd be interesting to see if they push their outside backs, almost play them more as wing backs. Try to exploit that and get some more chances.
Be a Kakana throw in. Going to be another Kakana throw in.
53rd minute here. That'll be snatched by the Kakana goalkeeper. Looks to send it up. Long ball played to the corner. Little too much on that.
Entering Kakana, number two, William Lam.
For Kakana, number two, Lillian Lam subs in.
Mangold on the run. Tackle put in.
It's going to be a throw in for Mangold. For Pulaski, taken by Mangold. Decker dribbling with the pass. Save there for the keeper.
Pulaski applying a little bit more pressure there. Still not able to get a clean look. Veronica Decker
might have something here. Can't get that one to go in. Good save by the keeper once again.
Minutes into this second half. Still scoreless.
Going to be a throw-in now for
Kakana.
Decker puts the cross in.
And it goes on top of the net. Very good cross, just ended up on top of the net. So we've hit the 18th minute, almost halfway through the second half. Going to be a foul on Pulaski. Free kick for Kakana. Nice header there. The pass to Decker. The cross almost went. Going to be a kind of throw in. And it will be another Kakana throw in.
Lily Burnt will check in for Veronica Decker.
As we are now halfway through the second half, still scoreless. And that's going to result in a free kick.
Foul on Sturdivant. I believe that was Kalen Wegen with the foul. This is dangerous position. Looking to swing this one in. Try and connect on a header. Pulaski's got their runners lined up.
And that kick is too much on that one.
Number 6, Rowan Flanagan, and number 18, Aaliyah Ison.
Here's Kakana entering Pulaski territory. For good combination play.
For the first time in a while. Ooh.
And that'll be a goal kick. Solid work there from the Kakana attack. Trying to put something together. Both teams have struggled in that final third. Pulaski with a chance.
No.
Crosby, I will turn your camera off.
Saved by Likes. We're going to have a foul called on that. That aerial duel.
So I was trying to switch to you, Logan, but I accidentally switched to Crosby. And Logan was like, he was zoomed in.
Another free kick awarded. Evelyn Duell. Pulaski unable to get a break there, but does get the ball into that final third of the field.
In for the goal is number 22, Anna Hahn.
Long ball played. And she'll just shield out.
Truck and Barad on the throw-in.
Alina Harnowski for the Red Raiders, the one shielding that one out wisely. You know to throw this in.
Stino's going to do another throw in here. Never mind, it's going to be Kakana's. As we are in the 27th minute of the second half.
Julie Truckenbrod.
To Decker.
Truckenbrod playing defense. Just clears that out of danger. Ruth Kraus able to collect it. And here's Stino.
Truckin' Broad. As we enter the 29th minute of the second half.
These final stages of the game, both teams looking for that breakthrough goal to just break this deadlock.
You know they don't want this to end in a tie.
Right now it is looking like draw territory.
And you know, nobody wants to see that, but it's been a good game. We might have to see that. Just nobody's been able to find that one goal that will go in. As we now enter the final 10 minutes of the game, as we are at the 70th minute.
Shut the window. Veronica Decker with that heavy touch down the sideline.
As we have 9 minutes left in this one. Good kick there. Mangold.
Ellie Mangold with the throw in the corner. Josie Steno crosses to the middle. Steno's also got quite a bit of soccer in her family. Both of her older brothers played, Will Steno and Connor Steno. Trekking Brode with a nice tackle.
As we enter the final 7 minutes of this one. Big drop kick there. Veronica Decker looking to get to that one. Gonna be a Pulaski throw-in.
Steno sends it all the way across.
Right to the keeper.
This game coming down to the wire.
Yeah, final 6 minutes. Mangled the pass. Gonna be a good call to throw in.
Maya Promer to throw this in for the Ghosts.
Very important throw in.
Decker showing the speed. Plays it into the middle. Still in the mix.
As we are in the final 5 minutes. This is going to come down to the wire in these final 5 minutes.
Every attack here getting exciting as a goal surely spells a victory. As far as this game's been going, at least.
It's going to be a...
Steno looking to send this into the box.
Very important free kick here. Can't get it there.
Both defenses standing strong. both teams surely happy about how their defense has been tonight. Both pitching shutouts.
And that is a for sure a foul here with 4 minutes left. That could be costly for Kakana if Pulaski is able to take advantage here. That's going to give us a corner kick. Kakana has defended these well so far. This might be the most important one of the game.
Pulaski with quite a few numbers in the box.
Here we go. Three minutes remain. This one is coming down to the wire.
Little Logie trying to shield off.
And you could tell she was frustrated there. Two and a half remain. Kakana throwing. Might be looking to launch this one far. Two minutes remain.
Pulaski with a chance here.
Trying to get it up to Decker.
Closing in on that 80th minute.
Pulaski might have an opportunity at one final cross.
See, Logan's glitching on
too. 1 minute left.
1 minute remains in the game.
This is going to be a make or break right here. Here we go in. This corner kick.
Pulaski resets.
30 seconds remain. They gotta hurry.
Referee stops the clock. Just gives a warning.
Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five,
and
four,
that
three,
is gonna be all
two,
she wrote.
One.
This will end in a tie. This was a very defensive game.
0-0 draw. As we predicted, it would be a close game, as it always seems to be when these two teams meet up.
Closer than we expected, though. As we thank you for tuning into this RSN broadcast.